Hey guys, so this week I'm going to take you through 9 female fitness home workouts that you can do from home. Starting with an upper body day, we're doing single arm lateral raises. This exercise is great for developing your shoulders. Make sure that you are keeping that mind-muscle connection. We're doing dumbbell tricep extension, 3 sets of 12 repetitions. Make sure you are squeezing. Front raise, 3 sets of 12 repetitions. This also works the shoulders as well. So I'm going to take you through 9 workouts. We're going to go through a lot of body parts. Make sure that you pause this workout since it's not a follow along and just do the exercises. We have a dumbbell back row, 3 sets of 12. Make sure you're squeezing your back. You want to emphasize the mind-muscle connection when you're doing these to get optimal muscle growth. Next, we have the push-ups where we're doing 3 sets of 12 repetitions. Make sure that you are feeling a stretch as you're doing this. The next workout is a sculpted abs workout. We're doing crunches, 3 sets of 20. Make sure that you're focusing on having optimal engagement. Lying leg raise for 3 sets of 20 repetitions. Make every single repetition count to get the best out of this workout. Next, we're doing a bird dog with pulses. We're doing 3 sets of 12 on each side. The pulses just means that you have to add just a quarter of a rep, not a full repetition. This way we are adding as much intensity as possible throughout this entire workout. So take a pause if necessary, take a 1-minute break in between sets, and make sure to stay hydrated. The next workout we have is a mountain climber. We're doing 3 sets for 1 minute each. We're working our entire core throughout this workout. Next, we're doing a high plank to a low plank. Do 3 sets for 1 minute each. Keep your core tight. Make sure you're breathing. Do never hold your breath in. That is counterproductive. Next, we're doing strong legs and glutes workout. Here, I'm holding the dumbbell goblet style. So it's tucked against my chest and I'm making sure that I'm driving up, focusing on the movement and doing it correctly. Next, we have a dumbbell deadlift. We are doing 3 sets of 10 repetitions. Here, I'm feeling a stretch. Next, we have rounded kickback, 3 sets of 20 repetitions. Make sure you're squeezing on the way out. Make sure you're actively fighting against the band, utilizing every single repetition to get better engagement. Next, we have a banded hip abduction. We are doing 4 sets of 20 repetitions. Make sure you're squeezing on the way out and focusing on that mind-muscle connection. Okay, so next we have a dumbbell bridge. Whenever you're doing any bridge or hip extension movement, you want to make sure that you're squeezing at the top, squeezing the glutes at the top. This is important to get maximum development. Next, we have around the world. We're doing 3 sets of 20 repetitions. So this is kind of like a kickback, but we're utilizing the entire range of motion from the sides as well. The next workout is a leg goals workout. We're doing a squat with 3-second iso hold for 4 sets of 12 repetitions. So once again, you can see here that we've added more weight. So we're getting stronger every week, and this will ensure that we get maximal development. Next, we have a B stance, single leg deadlift. If you cannot do this one, the regular deadlift will work just as effectively. Make sure that you're aiming for a stretch, feeling it in your hamstrings, your glutes, and not your lower back. Next, we have a reverse lunge. We're doing 4 sets of 12. Here, we're using a GHR. If you don't have this one, you can just do it on the floor. Or you can use a Smith machine or a barbell or just regular dumbbells. Next, we have a single leg hamstring curl. We're doing 3 sets of 12 repetitions. Make sure that you're squeezing the hamstrings and you're keeping your body in a bridge position. You can see I'm putting my fingers up here so I'm not utilizing my upper body and overcompensating. Next, we have a side step up. We're doing 4 sets of 12 repetitions. The next workout is an hourglass upper body workout. We're doing front raises for 4 sets of 12 repetitions. So here I'm squeezing my shoulder and making sure that my core is super tight, my posture is correct. That way I'm ensuring that I'm gonna get stronger and I'm gonna get better at this lift. Next, we have weighted triceps. Here I'm adding a plate. You don't have to, but it will help challenge. Close grip push-ups. Once again, these are intermediate workouts. If you find that these are too difficult, just stick to the original push-up. Next, we have triceps extension. We are doing 4 sets of 12 repetitions. Make sure you're squeezing your triceps. Single arm lateral raise. 4 sets of 12 repetitions. Make sure you're squeezing outwardly. You should feel it under the armpits where the lats are. Okay, this will help create that nice hourglass shape from the top. And obviously, it will add more visual information, make us look more aesthetic. All right, so this is not a workout, but this is a 5-minute mobility routine. We're starting here with a pigeon. pigeon pose. This helps stretch out our hips, our lower back, and our legs. Next, we have a cat-cow. So we're keeping our belly button to our spine, making sure to take a deep inhale and a deep exhale. Try to match both so that you're getting optimal relaxation from this mobility routine. The next exercise is a low lunge. So I'm trying to lean as much as I can. If your flexibility is not very good, make sure you're breathing and slowly allowing your body to get into the position. This is a hamstring curl. I also recommend doing this workout before your leg days or just to get some movement throughout your day. So there's no perfect way of doing this, but just do it in whatever way suits you or in whatever way can benefit you and your health. So yeah, this is a front kick, great for hips. Next, we have a perfect leg day workout. We're elevating our heels. We're going for 3 sets of 12 repetitions. Next, we have a B-stance, single leg deadlift. Once again, if you do not know how to do a B-stance, don't do it, just do a regular deadlift. We'll be working the exact same muscle. But this is just for those of us who feel like we want and are up to having more of a challenge. So we're doing 3 sets of 12 repetitions. Make sure to lean into the stretch, okay? So you don't ever wanna waste the reps. You always wanna make sure every single rep is intentional. Next, we have a side lunge. We're doing this on the GHR. If you don't have a GHR, just do it on the floor. We're using dumbbells, Smith machine, or even using a barbell. So next, we have a single leg bridge. This is a unilateral exercise. If you find this is too difficult, do a regular bridge. Make sure you're squeezing at the top of every repetition. Next, we have a banded hip abduction. We're doing 3 sets of 20. Make sure that you're fighting against the band outwardly. Okay. So next we have a shredded upper body workout. Here we're doing a back row. This is a great exercise for the back. So we're doing 4 sets of 12 repetitions. If you're getting bored of using dumbbells, use a barbell. Next we have a tricep extension, 3 sets of 12. Make sure you're squeezing the triceps outwardly and keeping that core super, super tight. Okay, you wanna feel the triceps moving and contracting. Next, we have a dumbbell chest press. We are doing 3 sets of 12 repetitions. Make sure you are feeling a deep stretch on the chest, keeping that core super tight, and focusing on engaging your mind-muscle connection as well. So the next exercise is a push-up. We're doing 4 sets of 10 repetitions. This is just a regular push-up, but you can see we've added more sets. This way we are getting stronger every single week. Make sure you are following along and pausing so you can complete the sets. The next one is a dumbbell chest fly. We're doing 3 sets of 12 repetitions. Make sure that you're feeling a deep, deep, deep stretch on your chest. Next, we have a small waist abs workout. We're starting off with a side plank, holding each side for 45 seconds, repeating 3 times. This is excellent for not just the core, for the obliques, actually for the entire core. It's an excellent exercise. So keep that core super, super tight. Keep the belly button to the spine. Next, we have weighted sit-ups. We're doing 4 sets of 20 repetitions. You can see here I'm holding a plate. This is just to add more tension. If you find this is too difficult, a regular sit-up will help. For super tight, breathe out after every repetition, recover and breathe back. Side bend, 3 sets of 15 repetitions.